in a hotel room in the Travel Lodge in Gila Bend, Arizona, there was a body on the floor, in a pool of blood. He had marks on his arms. It looked like he had been in a skirmish. But no, folks, if you thought that, you would be wrong, because that was an overdose. An overdose, you might say. How could that happen? How could a man be laying in a pool of blood, gashes on the back of his neck, scratches on his arms, and it be ruled a suicide? Well, maybe that's the reason they haven't had a murder in over 100 years in Gila Bend. Maybe their coroner is a little biased. Or maybe it was foul play. On February 10th, 1973, in between Ajo, Arizona, and Gila Bend, Arizona, they were shooting a movie, The Man Who Loved Cat Dancing. And that movie was filled with Hollywood stars and Hollywood power. Sarah Mills was the leading lady, who was a British actress. And the man laying in that pool of blood just happened to be her business manager. She was married to a Robert Belt, but this 26-year-old David Whiting was her business manager. And now he was dead. The movie they were shooting, The Man Who Loved Cat Dancing, was supposed to be the next Hollywood hit. They had spent the money to bring in all the major players to a small town in Arizona. Well, it happened to be on February 10th, 1973, happened to be Burt Reynolds' birthday. And he decided that he was going to celebrate that birthday and bring a lot of the cast members. And they were going to go to Ajo, Arizona, to the Palomino Club to celebrate that birthday. But David Whiting was not invited to the party. So they went and they had a joyous occasion in the Ajo, Arizona area at the Palomino Club. They got back late, went to the Travel Lodge bar, and had a nightcap. Well, Sarah Mills and Burt Reynolds, the star of the movie, went to Burt's room. She came back at 3 o'clock in the morning, and David Whiting was in the room, and he had asked her, "Where have you been? Why have you been hanging out with strange men?" So was he a business manager? Was he not? She had stated that day that he had tried to make advances to her, and she had turned him down. Now, she was his employer to some degree, so that doesn't make a lot of sense. She said that the individual, David, had thrown her around the room, and she had yelled, and the nanny next door, who had Sarah Mills' child in the room next door, heard, got Burt Reynolds, and by the time Burt got there, David was gone. She, being afraid, not wanting to be alone, spent the rest of the night in Burt Reynolds' room. Well, the next morning when she went back to her room, that's when she saw the scene, the body laying lifeless on the floor. She said it was clutching a pill bottle. Now, remember, the story went that they'd been in a scuffle, but when the police came, it was much more than a scuffle, apparently, and there was Whiting laying in the floor. Now, they said he was clutching a pill bottle, but there was no pill bottle there. Reynolds said he had taken the pill bottle, but he forgot where he put it. The big power of Hollywood came down. All the Hollywood lawyers came down, and all of a sudden, even the people in Gila Bend, all the police stated that they'd been coached on what to say. And now, all of a sudden, Sarah Miles said that she had a physical confrontation with Whiting in the room, and that's where those scratches were from. You know, Jed Mulford Windsor of Gila Bend stated that he knew that Burt Reynolds murdered Whiting, but he was afraid that he would end up in a wood chipper, even as a judge, with all these high-powered lawyers and all of this money coming from Hollywood. They stated that the two would have to go to court. They stated we couldn't go to court. That's $25,000 we would lose. So they went to the coroner's inquisition, and that was it. And Burt Reynolds walked away from murder. You know, how could you live with yourself, I guess, the rest of your life? And I guess the reality of it is that I guess you do. I guess he did. Did he ever believe? Did he ever feel remorse? You know, we know he'd been partying all night. There was also people saying that he was doing more than just drinking. You know, Lonnie Anderson, his ex-wife, said that he was physically abusive to her, whether that be true or not. But this is a case of the reason why there's never a murder in Gila Bend, Arizona, because they just have a lot of people that want to kill themselves. It is funny how Hollywood and power dictate the law. So I guess you could say this was the case of the worst suicide in Gila Bend, Arizona. Burt Reynolds, the man who loved cat dancing, loved cat dancing.